Madison Square Garden, the Chicago Bulls, and the New York Knicks. It's the magical, mystical Jordan Road Tour 1995. The Bulls are 2-2 since his return, and one of the most asked questions in America, most often asked, is how is Michael doing? How is his return? Is he as good now as he was before?
Well, I think you have to look at it this way, Bob. He's only a few ticks away in each category from his career stats. Now, right there, you see for 9 years, you know, the minutes, the shot attempts, the foul shot attempts, and his percentages. Now, look, 39 minutes equal 24 shot attempts. Sure, the shooting percentage is down 39%. The reason his legs are not there. The foul shot attempts, getting to the line 7, is fantastic when you consider how long he's been away. The foul shooting will definitely improve. Two other stats. In his career, 6 rebounds, 6 assists per game. He's right at 4.5 each. Not bad for a guy who's been away.
Not only is this Michael comes to New York, but this happens to be also a crucial time and a crucial game in the Eastern Conference, Hubie. If it started today, the playoffs, it would be the Knicks and Bulls.
Well, as you look at the Knicks in the 3 spot with 23 losses, they're only 3 games ahead of Charlotte. Now, as you drop down, Cleveland is only 3 games ahead of Chicago on the loss side. Anything can happen, but this is a twofer in regards to New York and Chicago.
Now, there's a lot of stories in this game, but quickly headline them for us.
Well, the way I look at it, this is a half-court, nasty defensive series. If you get 100, what happens? You win the lottery. Let's look at the matchup. Starks plays Jordan better than anyone, even better than Joe Dumars over the last 4 years. Then at small forward, Pippen, the great creator and also leading rebounder at 8 a game, can Mason, Bonner, and Smith match up. Pat Riley is nervous about Charles Oakley playing Kukoc in the open floor, and we haven't even touched on Patrick Ewing and Chicago's centers by committee.
Let's take a look at the starting matchups for tonight's ballgame.
Well, the Pippen and Bonner, and then by committee, Smith and Mason, should really be an outstanding matchup along with the Jordan Starks.
Now let's go to Craig Sager. Craig.
Well, Bob, prior to his premature retirement, nobody guarded Michael Jordan straight up better than John Starks. He would use not only one, but both hands to check him on the perimeter and to push and shove him in the paint. The rules are a little different now. However, Starks told me moments ago, the Knicks still plan to have him go one-on-one, no double teaming. He wasn't intimidated before and he's not now, and he says he's eager for the challenge. Bob.
Moments away from tip-off, there is John Starks. He's been a little bit of a slump lately offensively, but he does play Michael Jordan very well. Not only that, but Patrick Ewing, of course, playing against the center by committee for the Chicago Bulls, who will be Will Perdue, Luke Longley, and Bill Wennington. And, of course, Tony Kukoc starting at the power forward spot, and he'll be dealing with Charles Oakley. And there is number 45, in case you haven't heard it already. Jordan wore that number in junior high, wore it as he went to baseball for 18 months, and has returned with 45 because number 23 is retired and hanging above the rafters at the new United Center in Chicago. So Michael comes back to New York City. He loves playing in this gym.
Well, this place brings it out of you. And that's why we brought at the top that this is a nasty defensive series. This team, both teams do not like one another. Their styles of play are methodical. One is a low post power game, New York Knicks, relying on 17 three-point shots a game. And the other one is the famous triangle offense.
Ewing wins the tip with Perdue. Charles Oakley matched up against Pippen early. Perdue got a piece of that. Perdue with a block on Ewing early in the game. Kukoc on the run. Jordan, 15-footer. Look out.
With Charles Oakley responsible for crashing the offensive boards, Kukoc is going to have an opportunity to get out on the break, providing other people rebounds.
Scottie Pippen knocked that out of play. Pippen leads the NBA in steals, and we know that Michael Jordan one time was the best defensive player in the NBA. Starks loses Jordan, speaking of defense, and hits it from a corner. That's tied at 2.
Now that's big, because in the last 4 games, Starks is shooting 24% from the field and 24% in threes. I like this. Post up Starks, force them to double team.
Illegal defense called against the Knicks.
The rule is that once you break the foul line, to help, you must go all the way and double team quickly the player with the basketball.
Opening minute of play from Madison Square Garden, tied at two. Jordan's return to New York City. These two teams could be matched up in the first rounds of the playoffs. Jordan is 2 for 2 to start this game. Remember, he's coming off the game-winning shot and 32 points against Atlanta on Saturday night. Quickly back, Bonner. Out of bounds, Bulls ball.
Never leave your feet unless you're going to shoot the ball first. Bonner left his feet to make a fancy pass. They took away the passing lane, turnover.
Scottie Pippen handling, B.J. Armstrong, Tony Kukoc, Will Perdue, and Jordan, the starters for Atlanta. Fronting Jordan this time is Starks. Kukoc on the drive. Oakley got it away from him. And now Ewing, troubled by Kukoc. Knicks come back down two.
Now, if you notice early, there's a lot of bumping going on and no calls.
Perdue caused Patrick Ewing to change that shot. The ball will belong to the Knicks.
Oh, I like Perdue. Perdue's having an outstanding season, Bob. He's improved in minutes, points, rebounding, and also shot blocking. Doing an excellent job.
First, the ball went to the Bulls. Pippen defended one-on-one by Bonner. Clear the floor. Up and under. Scottie Pippen.
Scottie Pippen is murder. He's first in all of the major categories for the Bulls. And he's in the top 10 in two categories. Now, right now, I like this. The Bulls are trapping, and the reason is that Pippen is matched up with Oakley, and he can get back to Oakley.
Ewing this time a 10-footer over Will Perdue. Patrick with his first basket of the night. Bulls 6, Knicks 4, 9:47 to go, first quarter. Jordan isolated against Starks.
Yeah, I like that. So they send the two guys through, leaving Jordan one-on-one with Starks. Now he can get that shot at will.
Jordan's first miss of the night, hit his first two jumpers coming out. He has 4 of the Bulls' 6 points. Pippen has the other one. Bonner starting in place of Anthony Mason, who was suspended for 5 games by Pat Riley. Mason is back now. Perdue getting around Ewing and is whistled for the early foul. And that's something we talked about earlier when Bill Cartwright was playing center for the Knicks. He had more leeway to push Patrick Ewing around.
Well, they missed Cartwright and Grant from the defensive end of the floor. They had the liberty of moving defensive people around. An incidental contact was never called.
Scottie Pippen with the personal foul on Charles Oakley, who would have been open for the layup otherwise. Oakley, of course, a former Bull.
Now, Scottie is matched up with Oakley. Now, Oakley is usually at the top of the circle. Anytime the ball goes into the post, Oakley is going right down to the front of the rim. They are going to challenge Pippen to double team and then allow Oakley to free himself up in the painted area.
Charles Oakley. Patrick Ewing, one-on-one against Perdue. He'll take the jumper from there. Not this time. Bonner steals the rebound from Kukoc. Starks.
Three for John Starks. And the Knicks have their first lead of the game, 7-6.
You have to remember, John Starks averages 7 3-point attempts per game.
Scottie Pippen sees the opening, takes it in, almost threw the ball away, but comes away with a hoop anyway, and we have a seesaw lead here of 1 point. Bulls back on top, 8:49 to go in the first period. Starks misses from three. Nice. Beautiful pass from Oakley to Bonner.
Nice pass. Good call, Bob. Bonner's out there as the garbage man. Finish on the break, offensive boards, take it strong.
They're going to keep going to the well with Jordan and Starks. Double team, Oakley gets there, too late.
And did you ask, is he back? Oh, come on.
Lightning.
What a move.
On the double team, remember, Charles Oakley's a good defensive player, and Starks is quick.
Well, if you remember, see, he's gone to the middle his last 2 times, so that time you could see he catches Starks leaning, and then it's just over.
Kukoc with a foul for Chicago.
Now, remember, Michael is not the normal post-up guy. He has, you know, all kinds of moves, plus the quickness, and then the jumping ability.
Starks misses for three. Who's there? Offensive rebounder, Charles Oakley.
This is what we said. The 4 and 5 position of Chicago will be challenged in all of the big games, taking care of the defensive board.
Jordan starts out on fire. Michael is 4 of 5, has 8 points in the first quarter. He had 18 versus Atlanta in the third on Saturday night.
Every shot tonight, high percent. Now remember, Starks is wearing Michael down a little bit. Now they've been chasing off all of the screens, and that's tough for Michael to keep fighting all of the screens underneath.
Starks finds Bonner, who stays with it and gets the putback.
Hey, Bonner is a tough dude. He'll put his body in there. The foul before the basket on John Starks.
Now in the early going, Bob, if you have not seen the Knicks in the last couple of months, if you score, Chicago scores, they will inbound that ball quickly, go up the right side of the floor, and they're looking to post right away or shoot a three.
Tipping against Bonner. 7:19 to go first quarter. Isolated. Tipping on the drive. That's Kukoc from 15. Loose ball, Bonner. He gets a lot of loose balls. Patrick Ewing against Armstrong. Armstrong did a great job keeping it from scoring.
Well, I like the Knicks attack this way. They need to get easy baskets. They cannot just play half court. The team is a little older. Oakley has missed 32 games this year with surgery to the toe. Charles Smith has missed 6 games because of bang up to one of his knees, which he had operated. He had both knees operated on in 92 and 94. So you know yourself, they need to get the easy hoops.
Patrick Ewing, 24 plus points a game, 11.3 rebounds, a little over 2 block shots. Once again, the man for the Knicks.
Well, once he got into playing shape, January 1st, he spent 2 months. The team was 12 and 12. Since then, 31 and 11, and Patrick Ewing is on fire.
Knicks by 3. Jordan down low. Illegal defense. That's the second call against the Knicks.
Well, the Knicks now definitely have been surprised by the continual posting of Michael Jordan. In all the years that we have done their playoff games, you have never seen him in the post that many times.
Knicks 15-13. The Bulls added a point on the technical free throw by B.J. Armstrong after the illegal defense called against the Knicks.
Now, Michael Jordan is in here on the post. Now, watch as Scottie Pippen puts the ball in. He will cut and clear and set a screen. Also, from the corner of the triangle, Armstrong will go back door. So if either of the players double-team, they are open for a layup. So watch what happens. The Knicks go through, play them honestly. That allows Jordan to take Starks in a one-on-one situation.
Action back in on the court. Bonner with a steal on the intended pass from Kukoc to Pippen. Bonner! Derek Harper on the layup, and the Knicks 17-13 with 6:40 to go in the first quarter.
You cannot be careless with Bonner and Starks and Harper out there. All three guys are great at playing the passing lane.
Jordan, 16-footer. He's on fire. Michael Jordan has 10 points, is 5 out of 6. And Hubie, you pointed it out. All high percentage shots.
Yeah, you have to like it. See, nothing is rushed. A great steal by Kukoc.
4-on-1, Jordan.
Look out.
Fouled by John Starks.
Now that was a throwaway foul by Starks. See, I like that. I like that. Do not allow Jordan to ignite the house with a dunk.
Actually, Harper got him. Either one could have been called for the foul. Harper comes down and gets him there.
Yeah, you're right. That's good. That was a throwaway by Harper. Smart play. Make Michael go to the line. Now he showed you at the top through his career. Michael, outstanding three-point shooter, 85%. This year, 83%. He's getting to the line 7 times a game. He only did it 9 times throughout his 9-year career. So he's almost on target.
He's only missed 6 free throws since he's been back. I've been doing the game during 5 of them. A little concerned. Oakley missing from the perimeter. Armstrong. Jordan missed 4 free throws in the game against Orlando in his home opener in Chicago. Pippen is fouled on the hold.
You know, we just had, it was interesting, Bob. Pippen has, right now, Oakley matched up with him. As soon as he caught the pass, he yelled for Kukoc to clear. He was going to take him one-on-one.
Oakley can't play him out there.
Absolutely not. Now, Charles can play him if he can put a forearm on him or through his number.
Put him on the low block. Pippen on the drive. The whistle on Anthony Bonner before the shot. The Knicks have a 1-point lead. We have 5:50 remaining in the first quarter of play. In case you've dialed in late, you've missed double figures from Michael already. He has 11 points.
Now you see the numbers on Pippen. Naturally, Scotty, last year and this year, blossoming into, outside of the centers, you know, the best player in the league at any of the other four positions. Because not only does he get the points for you, he leads the league in steals, he leads forwards in assists, and then the three-point shooting. But what I like is he's the leading rebounder at 8 rebounds a game for a small forward. Now here's your trap.
And the Bulls have regained the lead by one. Oakley has that shot, decided not to take it.
I'm surprised because he likes that jump shot from there.
Eric Harper now being guarded by Scottie Pippen. Now Kukoc on the switch. Offensive foul on Charles Oakley. And that's the second on Oakley and a technical.
Yeah, and see, the call by Salvatore was, he set the screen, and then as he was rolling, used his forearm to wipe Pippen out.
I don't think Charles has finished chatting with him about it either.
And he must be careful right now because he swore at the ref, and that's why he got the tee. Now, right there, you have a nice penetration by Harper. No way can Kukoc play any of the Knicks off the dribble.
Armstrong, 88% free throw shooter, misses the technical. The Bulls only shoot 72% as a team.
Oh, yeah, and we know that's like 21st in the league.
Oakley sits down now.
But there is a little tension here tonight, Bob.
I'd say a bit. Charles Smith checks in.
Even the scalpers are saying there are no tickets to be scalped.
How about it? Nobody wanted to give them up.
That's right.
And Corey Blunt is in for Chicago now. In place of Kukoc at power forward. 10 to shoot. Jordan, pull up. 13 points for Jordan with 5 minutes to go in the first quarter. 6 out of 7. Mercy. In the post to Ewing. Good pass out of the double team. Smith is open. Back to Ewing. In the paint. Who got him? I think it is Corey Blunt. On the turnaround.
Well, Patrick has been very, very active. 3 games ago, Patrick sprained his left ankle. There was a rumor that he might not play Saturday night against the Clippers or maybe Sunday versus Seattle. He showed up both nights, had excellent performances, and was running like a deer.
There you go. We told you that he was 24-11-3-2-1. You see where he ranks in the NBA.
Now for Patrick, they are excellent stats. The field goal percentage of over 50%, a major key.
5 minutes remaining in the first quarter. The Bulls 20, Knicks 19, and for these two teams, a high scoring first period.
Yeah, but we know that it will slow down to a walk as we move along.
Open man is Blunt. He traveled. Early first step. Now, would they call that on 45?
Yeah, well, the thing there was, Bob, it was so obvious, okay? He dragged the pivot foot. You can lift your pivot foot as long as you dribble or pass, but he dragged the leg, and it was too obvious.
Starks into Michael Jordan. They'll call him for his first personal.
Well, that was a pretty good anticipation by Michael. I thought Michael did a nice job in getting there. See? Right now, you're going to want to see, but he was moving. Yeah. Now, what's the problem in Stark's game? He went 7 games once he injured his left shoulder without getting to the foul line. John Starks is a penetrator, in-your-face, take-it-to-the-front-of-the-rim type of a guy. He is only averaging 3 foul shot attempts per game. That is not the John Starks that we know of, and you have to consider that he does not want to get whacked on that left shoulder.
Jordan spins past the double team, changed the shot, threw it away. Bonner on the run.
Nice Harper. Pass.
Bonner kicks it out. Starks misses the three. Rebound Blunt. But Pippen has Armstrong.
Oh, major jam.
Wow.
Fouls him hard. Now, right now, this is going to be interesting. Should they give him a hard foul, or did he go for the block? They are giving him just a block, call, and a foul. Now, because they're saying that he goes for the block. Now, you be the referee in this. Just watch how high up Pippen gets on this side. Now, remember, Charles Smith is a shot blocker. Okay, so they are giving him the benefit. Now, if they would have called, oh, yes, now they're changing it.
Yes, they did. After a committee meeting, our officials, by the way, are Bennett Salvatore, Lee Jones, and Monty McCutcheon. They're still discussing it, Lee Jones and Bennett Salvatore. 22nd timeout has been called while we sort this out.
No, you see, the initial call was basket good, one shot, right. Not a hard call. The referees just confused it as the man who made the call, McCutcheon, was at the table. This is a one shot. Now, watch out for the rest of the game.
Pippen gets the bounce. Bulls now build a three-point lead. The biggest lead for either team has been of three. Pippen 9, Jordan 13. Bonner from Ewing, he's fouled. Corey Blunt.
Now it's two quick ones. If you're astute tonight in your armchair watching this game, you notice that at half court, Scottie Pippen continues to trap out here at half court because his man is on the other side, but he now, Bonner, is breaking to the front of the rim, and he has taken advantage of Pippen on the last three foul shots. Now, Chicago is going to be tested. Are they going to change their strategy right now?
Anthony Bonner at the free throw line. Bonner, of course, played his basketball in college at St. Louis University. Jordan gets a rest. Pete Myers comes in. Jordan with 13 points as he gets his first rest of the night.
Now you're saying, well, why are they trapping at half court? The reason is to slow the Knicks down, do not allow them to get the ball up quickly, and Oakley or Bonner is a trail man. But right now, they are sending Bonner quickly right to the paint.
Jordan with some intelligence from the front line for General Jackson. 23-22 Bulls, 3:59 to go in the first quarter of play. 10 on the shot clock. Pippen and Jordan have 22 of the Bulls' 23 points. Pippen stripped away. Derek Harper.
Oh, what a move!
Yes, Derek Harper. He said he was so excited to play in this game, but he said the only thing that was bothering him, Hubie, is that his youngster was more excited about Michael being here than Daddy playing.
That's universal, not just here.
The lob into Perdue, not well done, but tried to get it over Ewing. Bad decision. Bonner, Knicks 26, Bulls 23. Phil Jackson's going to get a timeout pretty soon.
Well, right now, the Knicks are fronting the post on the triangle. They have just forced two turnovers and are scoring in transition.
New York on a 6-0 run. They're on their feet at the Garden.
We'd like to show you the strategy by the Knicks. You're going to see Chicago come out here and form the triangle. Here's the triangle right here. Now watch Patrick Ewing front the post. Now as the pass comes in, he's going to create the turnover for the second one in as many possessions. Now, early in the game, they played behind the post. Now they are fronting, and they are looking much, much better.
And Anthony Bonner, who got that, has 8 points. His season high is 11. Chicago shooting 82%, but they have 6 turnovers. Jordan back in, wicked it, missing. Longley back in, tipping it loose. Derek Harper with the ball. Knicks by 3, 2:57 to go in the quarter. Anthony Mason, who just checked in, goes easily to the hoop. Also, Larry Krystkowiak in for Chicago. Pippen, Longley with the board. He's 7-2. And he's fouled.
He was fouled 7 times, and they finally got the 7th one. Okay.
You know, that's the limit. I think they said, foul me 5 times, okay.
No, they were testing him, Bob. That was a test, okay?
Luke Longley, who's been getting better and better with his offensive game, part of the three-headed center for the Bulls, as he has recovered from his injury. You can see that his quickness and his feet are right quite quick, and he plays well on that low block.
Well, Bob, he missed 27 games because of the injury. He's only given them 17 minutes a game, but he's a scorer. He's getting 6 points, 4 rebounds, and he can shoot a high percentage for you and do some damage because of his size.
And I'll tell you what else he is. He's an excellent free throw shooter. for a big man. That's something that hurts Purdue, only shoots around 61%. Longley, when he gets fouled, will probably knock him down. It's a four-point lead. Knicks over the Bulls, 2:33 to go, and that stops an 8-0 New York run. Harper starts it all over again over B.J. Armstrong. Knicks with 30 first-quarter points and 2.5 minutes to go in the quarter. Pippen and Jordan. 8 to shoot. Jordan, pull-up jumper. That's a tough shot. He has 15.
Now, he created that all by himself. There was not a shot there. Starks played him as well as he could, but once again, the athletic ability and the height on the rise of the shot.
Mason in the front line for New York with Ewing and Bonner. Starks kicks it to Bonner to Harper. 7 to shoot. Double team. 4 to shoot. Starks punched away by Pippen. Nice. Oh, those long arms.
Ended up. See, he's not looking to get the ball out. That's one of his negatives in his game. He must understand that as soon as he gets the ball, he's got to get it out. If you're going to play small, then you need transition hoops.
There you go. In the air. Nowhere to go. Armstrong turnover. Anthony Mason to John Starks. Back to Mason. Krstowiak on Starks. He can drive on him. And Sid gets it inside of the mismatch. And Michael Jordan. No, they're not going to say. They say it was Luke Longley, not Michael on the foul.
Well, Mason is having a banner season. Not only is he giving them 10 points, but he's also the third leading rebounder with 8 rebounds a game. But what he has really done is improve his field goal percentage. He's shooting 56%. Look at that last column, over 49 for his career. You can see the rebounding is up as well as the points.
Hubert Davis has checked in for New York, too. Wears number 44 out of North Carolina. Hubert Davis, of course, an excellent perimeter threat. And speaking of perimeter threats, coming in for Atlanta now, Steve Kerr is Larry Krstowiak steps out.
I'm going to make a statement now, and it's funny because we're not reading it here in New York, which is surprising. This is the first time that the Knicks are healthy all year. Oakley's not out, Smith's not out, Mason's not suspended, somebody's not injured. This is the first time their 9-man rotation is healthy this season.
I think I said Kerr was in for Atlanta. Atlanta wishes he was in for Chicago, of course. 32-26. Knicks have their biggest lead of the game now. Now, can Bonner play Michael?
Well, that was interesting.
Long range, nothing.
Michael says, yeah, he can stay with me. And he was right on the ball. He might have even flicked that shot.
8 out of 10, Bulls full court. Jordan, 17 first quarter points. Nice move by Derek Harper, who, by the way, has not missed. He is 4 out of 4 for 8 points. The Knicks continue to lead by 6 with 40 seconds to go in the quarter. Jordan, he hits 3. What else? It's 20 first quarter points for Michael Jordan.
And we did say low scoring. I did say that. Nasty defense in your face if someone gets 100. But we still have 3 more to go.
Ewing ball fakes Jordan out of the way. Takes the jumper. 21 seconds to go. New possession for New York now. Shot clock is off. Now down to 15 in the quarter. Knicks up by 3. They'll take the last shot.
Harper's advantage, he shoots well with either hand off the dribble.
Good move. Kicks to Ewing. That's a good place for him to shoot. Doesn't get it. Jordan, that would not have counted. That's the only shot he missed this quarter, it seems like. Jordan, 9 of 11, 20 points, and scored the last 7 points for the Bulls. Bob Neal, Hubie Brown with you. We took some video home camera of our subway trip over to Madison Square Garden tonight for Michael Jordan. His first quarter, 20 points. Craig Sager, what do you have for us?
Well, Bob, there are 8 players in this Bulls roster who never played with Michael Jordan before. They've seen flashes of brilliance, but this is the first time they've seen him with a hot hand. He came over to the huddle like this, like his hand was steaming and on fire. They were laughing and they said, stay hot. Bob?
Jordan, 20 points, Pippen 9. That's 29 of Chicago's 31 from Jordan and Pippen. And Bonner has 8 points, 3 steals, 4 rebounds, and 3 assists. He's played very well for the Knicks. And remember, as we talk about Michael, the Knicks have the lead, 34-31. moment, second quarter. Jordan on the post up. Missed off the glass, only his third miss. Harper loses the dribble. Krestowiak, who's back in for Chicago. Krestowiak, Longley, Steve Kerr, Kukoc, and Jordan on the floor for the Bulls.
If you notice, the last three posts up by Michael have resulted in quick double teams by the Knicks.
Luke Longley from Krestowiak. Kept alive. Kukoc back to Longley. Try it again. Miss it again. Kept alive by Kukoc. Back to Kerr. Try it again. Miss it again. Kukoc. Kept it alive. Knicks come back.
Good call.
Traveling. Excellent play by Steve Kerr.
Excellent. Good call. And let's look at Chicago. Now with this second unit out there with Michael Jordan, they are big with Kukoc and Longley and Krestowiak out there against your ball club. You can see that was a heady move by Kerr and an excellent call by the referee.
Steve Kerr is doing a whale of a job. He's kind of the John Paxson. Of course, Paxson retired from those championship teams, is doing the Bulls radio now.
Well, there are only two players in this league shooting over 50% in threes. Detlef Schrempf and Steve Kerr.
10 to shoot, Jordan. Against Greg Anthony. Fadeaway jumper, not this time. Patrick Ewing with the rebound. Bulls 0 for 5 in the second period, still trailing by 3. Kick ball, shot clock.
With Charles Smith in the game, anytime that there's transition or a score by Chicago, Charles Smith will try to post immediately on the right side of the floor.
Greg Anthony, who's been the missing man in this Knicks lineup, getting some early action here tonight. He was not part of that three-guard rotation for a long time.
Well, they're trying to give Harper a little bit of a rest.
Speaking of Charles Smith.
Yeah, I like Charles Smith. Early in the season, Charles Smith hit over 20 points a game 9 times before he re-injured his knee.
Good coach. Looking for help from Longley on the pick and roll. Well played by the Knicks.
The Knicks trap is, if not the best. You got to tell me who the team is then. It's tying them and trapping the screen and run.
Patrick Ewing with an excellent defensive play. Smith open for the jumper. Not this time. Kukoc with a rebound. Knicks by 5. 9:48 to go first half. Michael Jordan, 20 points in the first quarter. He has not scored here in quarter number 2.
Oh, nice move.
Longley having a rough start offensively here.
Well, see, he should have dunked that.
Yes.
Because Patrick Ewing gambled, and on that spin, you take that strong with 2 hands and you dunk the ball.
Right between the legs of Patrick Ewing, Greg Anthony hit the pass exactly where you can put it. And now Herb Williams checks in as Ewing gets a rest. Patrick sits down with 6 points in the first quarter and only 2 rebounds. Longley isolated against Smith. You see the quickness of, I should say, Kukoc to Kerr. Rebound, Anthony Mason, 36-31 Knicks. Bulls have gone cold. Davis is not cold.
Oh, you must get up on him. He's a high 40 shooter as well as 44 in threes. So in transition, you know he doesn't take it to the rim that often, so you must go up and close the gap.
Bulls trail by their largest margin. Down 7. Two coaches foul. Now, why did he not take that shot?
A very good, very astute observation.
You hear from
that. They keep overpassing here in the paint, and the peripheral people here, they've got to start scoring, okay? Michael Jordan and Scottie Pippen cannot beat the Knicks by themselves. 2 against 8. It's not going to work. Everyone else must understand that they have got to finish the play.
Like that. Of course, that's Michael Jordan. Bulls were 0 for 8 in the second quarter until Jordan scored. And Jordan now with 22 points. Jordan and Pippen have scored all but 2 of the Chicago points. But long range, Greg Anthony.
Well, I'm glad to see Greg Anthony getting some time. 21 games this year he has not played. Coach's decision. He's shooting 33% in his threes. He's 34 for 100.
Knicks with their biggest lead, 41-33. That's 8 points. 8 minutes to play in the second quarter. And bad pass attempt by Krestowiak.
Give it up. Very rusty.
Anthony.
Oh,
missed it, but the tip in by Hubert Davis. Davis.
Never lay it up over the front of the rim when you can lay it up off the board. Fortunately for the Knicks, Hubert Davis following, not assuming. Bulls bench giving up some points here, and the Knicks have built a double-digit lead with 7:37 to go in the second quarter. They're on a 9-2 run. So many celebs here.
We're loaded here this evening with fans. Big stat right now. The Knicks have 8 steals. They only get 7 a game. They're 25th in the league. Are they up tonight defensively? I would think so.
I would say. Kukoc into the paint. Kicks it out. Kerr for 3. Kukoc keeps it alive, but Oakley comes up with it. This combination for Chicago has not been playing well. Davis inside Smith. Way too low. The jam. Counted and the foul.
At the other end of the floor, Chicago 1-for-10 for the quarter. And once again, we told you, transition, field goal, you must stop Charles Smith from posting up. And if you notice, he backed Pippen right under the rim. Now you're dealing with a guy at 6'10 at that small forward position who is basically a post-up player.
Pippen picked up the personal, his second. 45-33, Knicks now by 12. The Bulls have scored only 2 points in this quarter. And that was Jordan. Kerr picked up his dribble, almost got in trouble. Armstrong. He's fouled. Got Anthony, Greg Anthony in the air. That's his second person.
Now, B.J. Armstrong is a very valuable player here. He averages 14 points a game. If you notice, we have hardly even mentioned his name in a quarter and a half. He has not had a shot, and he's averaging 14 points. So you know the Knicks are zeroed into the triangle offense tonight.
Luke Longley decides to finally shoot it over Herb Williams, and Longley has an 0-for going here. Since he came off the bench for Purdue, he's missed 5 shots.
And you can't keep throwing fadeaway jump shots when you're 7-2. You've got to take the ball into the paint and attack the basket.
Knicks building confidence here in their building. Herb Williams missing. Pippen with the rebound. Remember, he's Chicago's leading rebounder at 8 a game. And the foul in the backcourt on Charles Smith.
Good call. Good call. That was a definite bump. And definitely prevented Pippen from taking the open floor and getting an advantage. Now, just watch this bump with Charles Smith. See, right there. And no question about that call.
Eddie has 3 personals. We'll have to go to the bench. Anthony Bonner comes in.
Yeah, but the Knicks just keep coming with guys.
And Bonner, who's been a star early.
Think about their forwards. Oakley, Mason, Charles Smith. Okay, and they just keep coming at you and hammering you in the head. And then Bonner, who's having a terrific game this evening.
Kerr off the screen and roll from Longley. He gets in trouble. 6 seconds to shoot. Kerr trying to create offensive foul.
Monty McCutchen calls any time that a guy sets a screen with the ball or a down screen, if you move, he's calling movement. So you have got to hold up tonight and hold your area.
Longley having the worst performance I've seen him in the last couple of months for the Bulls. Just picked up his second personal. Bill Wennington is going to get into the game for Chicago. Hubert Davis missing. Kukoc has been active on the boards. He kept it alive for Pippen. Knicks still lead by 12. Nobody scored in a while. Pippen misses the 3. Follow Kukoc. Saved by Charles Oakley. Here comes Greg Anthony.
Oh, nice.
Nobody watching Herb Williams. The Bulls looking very disorganized in the second quarter. They're down 14.
They're taking a 20-second. Excellent call by Phil Jackson. They have to rally the troops together. They have lost their confidence. Ed Bradley, not bad. We're just throwing out a minor name right now.
Another local newscaster there.
And what you have is, because they are not scoring, Bob, with the wide open opportunities, they're losing their confidence. They are not as sharp as they were in the first quarter in trying to get back and matching up defensively.
Okay, Craig Sager has some information on Derek Harper, Craig.
Well, Bob, the Knicks are making this run without Derek Harper. He was kicked in the right leg a few moments ago. He went in for some treatment. He's being worked on. I heard the trainer ask him if he is all right. Can he go back in? He goes, I have to. But that's why Derek Harper was 4-for-4, is not in the game right now.
Thanks, Greg. And that's why Greg Anthony, who has not been part of this guard rotation, has been getting some minutes here tonight.
Pat Riley told me today
They were rotating four guards into December. The team was 12-12. Anthony was doing a nice job. He said, that's enough of that. I'm going to a three-guard attack, 31-11 since then. You say, well, then why is he back to four guards? He's trying to give Harper a rest as they come down to the end of the season, so he'll have good legs for the playoffs.
Not a dumb move, and of course they have the 14-point lead anyway. Pippen held by Bonner before the entry pass. And you know what? This is maybe the longest rest that Michael Jordan's had in the five games he's played since his return.
Well, the last two games, 41 and 43 minutes. I think that the guy in charge of minutes was sleeping at the switch.
Bonner picked up the personal, his second foul. The Knicks defense has been smothering.
Chicago, 1-for-13 this quarter.
DJ Armstrong finally gets a shot off.
There you go.
Finally, it took him a quarter and a half.
They're now 2-for-14 this quarter.
Jordan will be back in momentarily. Michael has 22 points already. Ewing fouled as he runs into the big chest of Phil Winnington. That's his first personal, and Jordan is back on the floor. Starks is also back on the floor, and since Michael's return, we're going to check on the minutes he's played so far in this game. Keep you tracked on that. He's got quite a rest there for a while. Ewing at the line. At the conclusion of tonight's game, Hubie and I will select the Budweiser player of the game. There are about 15 candidates in this ball game.
Well, over Pat Riley's 4 years here in New York, as well as they have played every year over 50 wins, they play in peaks and valleys, and when they play other playoff teams, they have a tendency to always let you back. But you must shoot high percent.
Just like that from Michael Jordan, who has 24. And I want you to talk a little bit when we come back to the Bulls next time about their spacing, QB. Looks to me like they're pretty jammed together on offense.
Right now they're trying to work Starks on the baseline, but
what a pass from Oakley. But Kukoc was there to deny Bonner. 4 seconds to shoot. Bonner will try it again. Three. Anthony Bonner. Not this time. Kukoc with a rebound. And he has 8 in this game.
Michael Jordan recovered twice down on the baseline with Starks.
As Armstrong drives, he is fouled by Greg Anthony. His third. And Derek Harper back in the line. Greg Sager, our roving reporter here tonight, had that report on him kicked in the calf. Seems to be okay. He's a warrior.
Derek Harper is one of the tough individuals that we have in this league. You have to remember that he was drafted on the first round down in Dallas, had a sensational career, made the all-defensive team, second team on two occasions. He's 10th in the league. And what's that guy's name?
David Stern and David Harvey Stern. Schiller. Those are critical people. I'm going to get you a roster. Critical names to know here. BJ, 2-for-2. And the Bulls have cut into a single-digit deficit now. They are down 48-39 with just under 4 minutes to go in the second quarter.
All they have to do is pay attention, take high-percentage shots, and stop overpassing.
Ewing couldn't handle that pass from Anthony Bonner, and now the Bulls have the numbers. Jordan. Nope, he knew it was off soon as he shot it. John Starks on the run. Finds Harper, and then B.J. Armstrong found Harper.
Yeah, he should go right into Patrick.
Ewing being played by Pippen. There's the double team. Right into the arms of Jordan. It's 2-on-2.
Oh, yes, and a foul. You know, that was like slow motion. He was just gliding because he knew that just watch the step that he makes when he decides that he's going all the way. Boom, there it is right there, takes the bump. And the beautiful control of the ball with the one hand.
It feels like Beethoven has come back to write his 10th and 11th and 12th and 13th.
Remember what we said about the Knicks? Peaks and valleys, back to six.
Chicago on a 7-0 run. until that whistle. Jordan, 26 points, is 12 for 17. It's on Winnington, his second. From a sold-out Madison Square Garden, Bob Beal, Hubie Brown with you on the mystical, magical Jordan tour. Knicks up by six, 3:09 to go in the first half. Timeout on the floor. Jordan set out 3 minutes. New York outscored Chicago 11-2 in that stretch.
Well, just watch how he gets in here and then gives you the off in your face push. And then this one is just beautiful. Now notice how he brings it back to guide it, takes the hit, and then puts it in. And as you look up in the stands, people are high-fiving, and we're in New York.
You see that he's head up and down, and the two losses, that was against Orlando and Indiana, he was down, was up against Boston and Atlanta, and is definitely up here tonight. Pippen gets his own rebound. Actually, Kukoc picks it up. Give it to Michael. New shot clock. Jordan on the drive. Had to get rid of it. Nowhere to go down there. 48-42, Knicks by six.
Plenty of time here. 12 seconds.
Jordan isolated against Stokes. 5 seconds. Four. You see it on the lower left. Jordan, three moves.
Wow! 28 points for Jordan with 2.5 minutes to go in the first half.
And going away to the Bulls bench on that release.
9-0 run for Chicago since Jordan returned. He scored 7 of the points. It's a 4-point game. Only matched up down on the post against Jordan's former teammate. Mason with the rebound, kicks it back out. Harper wisely called for it. 2 minutes to go in the half. Knicks by six, Oakley from the corner. Johnny Pippen holding his left wrist, by the way, handling the ball right now, and you see him squeezing that left hand.
He's a stamina guy, though. He very seldom misses games, and he gives you the major minutes night in and night out.
10 to shoot. Jordan loves playing Starks.
30 points for Michael Jordan. 1:27 to go in the first half.
You know, Starks was in his face, right on his wrist, even got him on the wrist, and it did not disrupt that shot.
Harper on the drive, answers for New York. It's a 6-point Knicks lead, minute to go in the half. Great violinist Itzhak Perlman sitting to my left. He's looking on Jordan as though he's watching a virtuoso here tonight. Not this time, but first the foul.
Well, they're shooting the penalty. Right now, Starks, I don't care how many people play him. You could see they ran Ewing at him for the trap. He has the ability right now, tonight in this first half, the stamina to even push on the traps and split it and still create the open check.
Jordan hits the free throw now. That's 32 points for Michael Jordan. Coming up at halftime, the Reebok Halftime Report, Ernie Johnson in our Atlanta studios with all of tonight's scores and highlights, possible bonus coverage. Also, a lot of games happening in the NBA this evening.
Good move here by Phil Jackson. Corey Blunt is in the game for Pippen. The reason they do not want Pippen to pick up another foul.
With 58 seconds to go in the first half.
Plus, this is Corey Blunt is good on the point of their 1-2-1-1 zone press.
Starks tried to pass it to Ewing. Winnington stepped into the passing lane to knock it out of bounds. 16 on the shot clock for New York. Anthony Mason in. Last time I saw him play when he was suspended by Riley, he had the Statue of Liberty engraved in his haircut. This time it just says back to D. Harper found the lane very open.
It's interesting how he's not even being intimidated. No one is even rotating, and he continues to lay the ball up uncontested with the left hand.
And you were talking about Chicago's problems inside. They're being really exposed here against the New York Knicks tonight. Five to shoot. Jordan.
Yes.
He's fouled hard by Patrick Ewing.
See, he elevated for the dunk that time. He was going dunk all the way. He fooled Starks. Starks thought that he was going to the middle, and he just took it right to the baseline. Went for the elevate. Now, just keep an eye on this. He has him beat. Now, watch what happens. He's going dunk all the way here. But then you have the shot block. Patrick was going strong for the block. Keep an eye to the left. Now watch Patrick come in here.
Former teammates on the Dream Team. Patrick Ewing says, I know you're Michael Jordan, but this is my house.
Yeah, but that's, you know, that's good coverage. And plus the fact Patrick, one of the top shot blockers in the league. Naturally, he's going for that block, and you know you're going to have contact.
I didn't see a lot of remorse on the face of Patrick there. He knew what his job was. Knicks by four. Jordan has 35 first half points. If he were to stay on pace, he'd break his all-time record of 69, a game I was fortunate enough to see against Cleveland 3 years ago. 35 in the first half. Harper is fouled before the shot with 4 seconds to go in the half. Hubie, you've seen it all in your career. I don't know if there are words to describe Jordan. He's in New York at Madison Square Garden with 35 points against a man who plays him well, John Starks.
Yeah, but, you know, you're talking the greatest offensive player, you know, in the time now, because a lot of guys, Wilt was right there. Let's face it, yeah. He and Wilt led the league in scoring 7 times each.
Right.
But you are seeing him in a nice flow. Nothing forced. He's getting high on his elevation. Starks is right up on his hand, and yet, because of the size difference, he's shooting over Starks' hand. Then he has the confidence tonight in his ball handling. That's why I tried to bring out the point that he's even splitting the traps with the dribble. Now, that's hard to do when you are in great game shape, and we know this is only his fifth ball game. So you can see it all tonight. Plus, he's been hit in the air a few times, and he's been able to keep his balance and still score.
Into Ewing. He's fouled by Wennington, and we'll go to the line with 2.2 seconds. Michael Jordan said when he had the 32 against Atlanta on Saturday night, in his first three games, he felt like he was pressing and going to the game. He says he's letting the game come to him. That was were his words after the Atlanta game. And as you say, he's done that tonight, and he's been in the flow.
Well, I think a key was the fact that they posted him so many times in the first 5 minutes, allowed him to establish a game 15 feet to the rim.
Patrick Ewing with the free throw. Pat has 8 points in the ballgame.
A major issue in this first half, the lack of recognition by the Knicks of Patrick Ewing in the low post, and the fact that he can score. Now, I admit, the first 3 times he had the ball, he did not score. They blocked 2 of his shots, but he's 1 for 7 in field goals, but the only way to get him off that schneid is to get him going.
Kukoc with a very bad lob pass with 2.2 to go, but nothing to lose there. At the end of the first half, Knicks with a 6-point lead, exposing Chicago's weakness inside. New York Knicks lead it by 6. They were up by as many as 14 points. Michael took a 3-minute rest in the second quarter. The Knicks went on a run, got the 14 points. He came back in, 11-2 Chicago run, and brought it down closer here. And by the way, the record for an opponent scoring against the Knicks here is 50, held by Jordan in 86. He has 35 at the half. Hubie, I'm speechless.
Well, his performance is outstanding. The Chicago bench, 1 point, 6 different players have played. And you can see right here, Michael doing his thing. He just takes Anthony to the baseline. He's 14 for 19 from the field. That's one. Now just watch how well Starks plays him. Now, look at the different moves. The rocker now, as he comes back, look where Starks is. Right, you cannot play him any better than that. But he has the ultimate feel. The 35, 14 for 19, he played 20 minutes.
Well, it's a big game. You know it's big because Michael Jordan's here, and so is Craig Sager. Craig?
Well, Bob, although the Knicks have that 6-point lead, the talk going in and out of the locker room was all Michael Jordan. Following up on what Hubie said, Derek Harper was talking to John Starks and said, it's demoralizing. You think you play great defense, and he still makes the shot. Meanwhile, the Bulls have the attitude of the old playground code. We're invading somebody else's turf and having a whole lot of fun. But the Knicks still lead by 6. Bob?
I think you added a very important but there. The Knicks leading by 6. Hubie, this is an amazing stat.
Yes.
Chicago only 2 assists in the first half.
Now, we're talking about one of the top assist teams in the league. They average 24 a game. So, but what's happening in the triangle offense is anytime that they post up someone and two players cut through, they're ending it up in one-on-one basketball. But that's all they're getting. They're not getting anything out of the passing of the triple post or the triangle.
Kukoc with the ball, he traveled there. Kukoc 0 for 3 in field goals, no points in the first half, and Kukoc has been very lost in this offense.
Well, right now he has 5 turnovers, Kukoc. But he's the leading rebounder with 9. He has 4 offensive boards. So the old story, when you're having a bad night offensively, you've got to help out with the boards.
Perdue back in at center. He started there and played well. Then Longley Huntington came in. Bonner has 10 points. He had an excellent first quarter starting at forward for the Knicks. 58-50, New York up by 8, 11:24 to go. Opening moments, third quarter, Jordan. He has 37. Now remember, his career high is 69. He's on pace to break that should he continue at this level here tonight. And the most ever scored against the Knicks here at Madison Square Garden, 50 points. Jordan, in 1986, he has 37. Ewing, 18 feet.
Well, it's nice to see Ewing come on glued here now, because he's 2 for 8. He had a bad first half, 1 for 7.
Nice play by Pippen. The flop by Stark doesn't get called, but Ewing came over and fouled Pippen, and he'll go to one, and that's the third on Patrick Ewing.
Well, this was just a very, very heady. That was an offensive foul right there. Good ball fake. You're going to see the offensive foul, definite. Good head fake catches Ewing up in the air. Now, Pippen, with that field goal, has 11 points.
Make it 12 with the free throw, and it's a 5-point Knicks lead. Pippen on Harper. Bonner.
There goes Bonner again.
Fouled on the drive.
Now you gotta admit, when Pippen was playing Oakley in the backcourt, he could do that. He could trap, then throw it to Oakley, no penetration. Then the Knicks made a change. When Pippen picked up Bonner, they used Bonner as the guy. As soon as Pippen traps, there he goes, right to the front of the rim.
Thus having an excellent offensive game.
Absolutely.
Knicks by 5. Ewing double teamed by Kukoc, and he knocked the ball out of bounds. It'll belong to the Knicks.
You must get Patrick involved in the game, whether they get the shot attempts for him or at least make him a passer to the cutters going to the basket.
Nice. Powers pass Perdue, draws the foul. Kukoc came over to help out.
See, the man's on fire. He just, within the month, 5 straight nights, he scored over 30 points, tying a New York Knicks record of Bernard King, who did it a number of times. Now you can see right there, that's the first time that he's really gotten in with a strong move. Now he's 8 for 9 on the line this evening.
What a night. Madison Square Garden, springtime, New York City. Michael Jordan is bringing the house down with 37 points. It's a great place to be. Glad you could join us on TNT. 62-55 Knicks over the Bulls. Potential first-round playoff opponents.
I tell you, Armstrong only has 1 shot. He's 1 for 1 in this game.
Posting Jordan, he's fouled before he can get to the basket by John Starks, who now has 3.
Bob, no one guy can play him on the post. I mean, the double team must come quickly, because once he makes the catch, he's so quick a foot. Now that was just a great move, and then you know he's a dynamite passer.
B.J. Armstrong comes off the screen, misses the jumper. In 20 minutes of the first half, B.J. only had 1 shot. Bonner! Pippen got there late, committed the foul, and Bonner seems to be, the Bulls seem to have lost him.
Well, he's the X factor in this game. You say, now what happened? At the other end of the floor, Pippen went to the offensive boards, Bonner took off and went down the floor. That was a long run for Pippen just to catch up with Bonner.
The night that Mason was ejected when New York was playing and left and went into the locker room, We were here televising the game on TNT when Mason was ejected. Bonner had stepped in and was doing what he does now, getting all the garbage points. And of course, Mason wanted to go back in, had the argument with Riley, stormed out, and then got the 5-game suspension. But Anthony Bonner deserves the playing time.
Oh, he's playing great. And the big thing about it is, you see on the foul line, he's shooting 74% this year. For his career, he's only a 59% shooter, so he's definitely worked on that part of his game.
Bonner season high, 12 points.
Nice.
Inside Perdue. Nice pass from him.
That's the first time tonight that they found the man who was open after the Knicks trapped the pick and roll.
Speaking of trap, in the corner in front of us, Harper gets it down to Bonner, and he traveled with the ball. Knicks 64, Bulls 57, 9:32 to go in the third quarter. Chicago inbounds.
Anytime that the Knicks trap your screen and roll or your ball cross, you must have excellent ball movement and find the free man in the front of the rim. Now, they've only done it one time in two quarters and a few minutes here in quarter three.
Ewing stepped out on Jordan. It opened up the lane. Michael came in. Somebody got a piece of that, I think Starks. Now the Knicks have the numbers.
Oh, yes.
Starks, three, no. He stepped over the line.
Well, any fast break, 5-on-2, of course you stop and try for a three-point shot.
Chances are you'll get the rebound.
Yeah, the thinking there is that if you miss, boom, you got the rebound.
39 points for Michael Jordan. And if you dialed in late, I'm sorry that things didn't go your way today. We have 8:46 to go in the third. Jordan on a potential record-breaking scoring outburst here at Madison Square Garden, but the Knicks up by 7. Ewing's fadeaway jumper, no. Rebound, Jordan. Pippen into Perdue. Ewing had to step out. Harper fell down. Knicks have a 20-second timeout.
Yeah, good move by Pat Riley, because right now his guys are a little out of whack in the transition game.
Scottie Pippen very comfortable playing with Michael Jordan.
Well, I would hope so.
Right? Well, some people aren't like Kukoc.
Now, there's a nice move down inside. Perdue, the old story. He put Harper down on the floor. Harper was laying there looking at the referee for a call. And the guy is saying, yes, but the ball's on the other side of the floor, no one's paying attention.
Right. You know, Michael says he has a lot more respect now for Will Perdue. When he first came into the league, Michael wouldn't call him Perdue. He says he wasn't that good, so he called him Vanderbilt. Bonner, open man over there is Oakley. Kukoc on the foul, that's his third.
Hey, Kukoc is... biggest problem is finding someone for him to guard.
Yeah.
You know, he can't play the small forwards on the first units. They beat him off the dribble. And then if you do have a big guy who can put it down, you can take him.
Perdue with the foul, count the basket on continuation. And Patrick Ewing will go to the line. Patrick starting to heat up here. He has 15 now, as you pointed out earlier.
I just watched. This is a nice, good jump stop, see, and then step out. Patrick's got a ton of moves. And you know, once again, Kukoc is in. You gotta call that. Let's call that. Kukoc has been in on every single Ewing foul shot. Now, just watch as Ewing releases. When Ewing releases his foul shot, some nights he has a tendency to stop at the height of the shot before he releases it. And you have to pay attention or you'll be in the lane.
Perdue picked up his third foul. Knicks have an 8-point lead. 8 minutes to go, third quarter. Pippen running it from the point, now to Armstrong. John Starks living a nightmare tonight. Ewing steps out on Michael. That pulls him away from the hoop. 5 to shoot. Armstrong, big bucket. That's a 3 for B.J. Armstrong.
Well, you know, B.J.'s a great 3-point shooter. You know, you're talking about a guy who shoots 44%. He's one of the top that we have in the league. He only has had 2 shots. He's 2 for 2.
They're going to milk Ewing here. Now the double team as Pippen comes his way. Harper's open.
Nice.
Ball, Ewing blocked by Pippen. Harper. Rebound. Jordan. 5-point Knicks lead. Strong into the paint.
to Kukoc, who had a potential layup, but he saw Ewing coming, didn't watch the ball, and it went out of bounds.
That was a costly turnover. Yes. That should have been a layup. B.J. Armstrong, as soon as he saw Oakley on him, definite clear out. Let me take him one-on-one.
Would have cut the lead to three, as it is 69-64 New York. Starks over Jordan. They got a piece of it. Oakley was there to put it back in. 71-64 New York. 6:41 to go, third quarter. The intangibles of Charles Oakley.
Well, Charles Oakley is their true garbage man, the power low post worker. The Bulls were going to substitute Blount for Kukoc.
Kukoc for three.
They sent him back to the bench. And now that he made that three, he's going to stay there.
Bonner once again finds the lane open, gets it to Ewing. He's fouled. Purdue had to step out on him. They're going to him over and over again. We have a timeout on the floor. Kukoc called for the Purdue, and that's four. We have a timeout on the floor.
A key element in hurting the Knicks when they trap the screen and roll is that you must continue your movement on the other side of the floor so you have your triangle. Once they trap that dribbler, you must rotate the pass because then you will see the roll man will open up. Now just keep a total eye on this. You trap the dribbler, rotate the pass, that will open up the roll man as he goes to the basket. The busyness away forces the Knicks to play those people honestly, and that will open up the roll man.
It was Purdue who picked up the personal foul. He goes to the bench with four, and Longley checks in for Chicago now. Bulls 7-for-9 shooting in the third quarter, and the good news for the Bulls, particularly based on the first half, is that Jordan has only four of Chicago's 17 points in this quarter. Ewing misses them both. Oakley steals the rebound. A lackadaisical Longley and Kukoc didn't count on Charles Oakley's hustle.
Well, the Oakman is one of the best offensive rebounders in the league when he's healthy. He usually averages between four and five. Now tonight, he's pushing for that.
Five to shoot. Ewing steps away. Fadeaway doesn't go. Bonner is there. Oakley!
The Oakman says, I bring my lunch pail, I do my job, and you better put a body on me or I'm going to hurt you.
73-67, Knicks. Oakley, seven rebounds, five offensive boards, 8 points in the game, and oh, so much more. Kukoc drives past Oakley. He's fouled by Oakley, and Charles was not going to let him get the layup.
Now, well, you know one thing about Oakley. He makes his fouls count. Now, you're going to see this right now. See, he's going to blast him right now. He's going to make sure that he does not get up. Let's face it, 2 years ago with the flagrant fouls, he led the league with 11, and then they put in the major dollar fine. And if you notice, less fights, less flagrant fouls, and the players will attune when you take out those heavy numbers out of the monthly checks.
And it's made the game more attractive. Running out to commit the foul, Anthony Bonner. That's his third.
Just think tonight, Oakley and Bonner, the garbage that they are getting tonight and hurting you, and you're only 6 points ahead. That's why we said at the top, don't worry when you fall behind the Knicks. They always let you back. If you're a good team, if you're a playoff type of team, you can get back into the game. But just continue to run your offense and stay with the good percentage shots.
That was the 15th foul on the Knicks, so they're over the limit with 5:19 to go in the quarter. Harper called for that personal.
I tell you what, this young referee, Monty McCutcheon, just made a good move. He walked away from Pat Riley so he would not hit Pat Riley, okay, with a technical, because Riley was all over. And I like that. You like to see that. That's maturity. He walked all the way down. Hey, he'll listen to Harper because he knows Harper's a defender who plays hard and really gets on it. You got to see it right here. Well, that's a foul right there. He pushed them off. Now, Derek is saying, wait a second, forearm is legal, but not up in the shoulder. He threw him in the ball.
New York committed three fouls in 12 seconds. That technical foul, by the way, which was shot a moment ago by B.J. Armstrong, was on Derek Harper, and now Armstrong will get two more. And if he hits this, and he's an 88% free throw shooter, so bet on it,
It'll be a 3-point Knicks lead.
I'm happy for BJ because he's involved this half. And like we told you, he averages 14 a game. So you must find a way to get him involved, and they have.
11 points. Remember, he didn't have a shot in the first quarter. Bonner stopped by Blunt. Good defensive play by Blunt. That caused Bonner to travel and turn it over, and the Bulls can pull to within one or better on this possession.
Now, that was a blessing. You're going to see it right here. That was an offensive foul. The offensive foul before he traveled. Now, for the Knicks, want to travel.
Jordan operating. Fell down, got rid of it to Pippen. Back to Jordan. Three! And Jordan has 42.
Now listen, come on now. He was 1-for-10 in threes coming in.
Falling down, hit his man, Tonto. Scottie Pippen, who got it back to the long range. Patrick Ewing coming alive. What a ball game. 18 points for Ewing. Knicks by 2. These could be the first round playoff opponents in the East. Bulls call a timeout.
How would you like to have to open up with Chicago in a 5-game series with Michael Jordan, who neutralizes the crowd? The referees love him. They'll get the call on the road. Brutal.
This is the beginning of the series when Jordan was able to knock down the three.
Well, he finds Pippen in the corner. Now, when Scottie puts it on the floor, watch how Starks goes back in. That opens up Jordan. Now, when he hits this three, he is 2-for-3 this evening in threes.
Michael Jordan, 42 points. Doug Collins and I were there at Cleveland in 1990 when Michael had 69 on the Cavaliers. Of course, the 63 at Boston and 86 in the playoff game was kind of the arrival of Michael Jordan. Bulls within 2. Not this time. Ewing with a rebound. Bulls now 8 of 11 in the third period. Charles Smith posting against Blunt. Foul before the basket. It's on Corey Blunt, who has 3.
See, now that was just a minimal bump. And this is what we said. When you have Grant and Cartwright at those positions,
they don't get that call.
That's right. That's a non-call. You see? It's Corey Blunt. He's a young player, second year out of Cincinnati, trying to make a name for himself. And he is a talented young man. He's a shot blocker, and he's got a live body. But Charles Smith is very active down in that post-up area.
We've got to take a look at the scoreboard around the league. I hate to even go away for a second. We'll stay here, though. Golden State beating New Jersey.
Big loss. New Jersey.
And Milwaukee now trailing Dallas. Dallas playing very well of late. Lakers out in front of Houston at the half. Houston suffering. Phoenix trailing Utah. Big game out west with Utah and Phoenix. That's the Chevy scoreboard. It's going to be an exciting March and April for the NBA. There are a lot of great races in the West and East. Jordan pulls up, didn't get the bounce. Got everything else, took all the iron. 3-point Knicks lead, 3:38 to go, third quarter. Anthony Mason looking in the post. Gary Parker. Trying to get it down to Charles Smith against Corey Blunt, too.
Yeah, he had him pinned a couple of times. Here's your double team.
Pippen came to help. Longley kept it alive.
Now, Pippen is the one that definitely disrupted that shot.
You got that right. Bulls down 3. Armstrong looking for an opening.
Nice.
Yes. And Corey Blunt travels with the ball.
What a great pass. Now, Corey could have forced that shot, but he was trying to make the catch and then the drop-off pass.
Knicks by 3, 3 minutes to go, third quarter. Jordan with 42 points. Ewing is fouled by Longley.
Nice move by Patrick. That's the first time this evening that he has spun to the baseline and taken it all away. Usually he'll fade for that jump shot.
Longley's third personal foul.
The Bulls with this center by committee with Purdue, Longley, and Wennington. Purdue has played best at that position, but usually somebody steps up and plays pretty well every night. Of course, tonight, Ewing now with 19 points. 10 of 13, make it 11 of 14 from the line.
Now, the last great series that they had when Michael was involved in 93, the Knicks won the division and had the best record, 60 wins in the East. And lo and behold, Chicago wins. Well, the Knicks still have 8 key players from that team in 93. Chicago only has 4 players available from that championship team.
Yeah, excellent point. Longley has not scored tonight. Pippen to Armstrong. He's open. That's a 2 for B.J. Armstrong. Knicks by 3.
B.J., one of the best spot-up guys that we have in the league. He read that penetration by Pippen perfect.
Starks long on the 3. Longley with that big body. Jordan. Shot wouldn't have counted anyway. Anthony Mason picks up the personal. Jordan will go to the line.
The reason I said look up, B.J. was wide open running down the floor, and then if he's not going to get the pass, he drifted right to that left-hand side, and that's where you must pay attention, because he was spotting up for the 3, but Michael felt that he had it off the dribble.
And in terms of scoring, he did. Kukoc is going to come back in. Michael Jordan with 43 points, 7 of 8 from the line, 17 of 25 from the floor. Pippen will get a rest. Scottie Pippen's been productive tonight, too. He has only 12 points, but has a lot of intangible play tonight.
Well, just in the third quarter alone, Pippen has 5 assists.
Jordan is 6 points away from tying the most ever scored by an opponent at Madison Square Garden. That's 50, and it was scored by Jordan at 86. No basket.
Now, Mason came back from his 5-game suspension Sunday night at Seattle, and he came in with 10 points and 10 rebounds. And we told you, the big factor that he gives you is not only the points and the rebounding, but he is a terrific defender in the interior. He can play a center, big forward, or small forward. Quickness of foot and upper body strength.
Hubie, it's obviously there's been adversity on this Knicks team and controversy between Mason and Riley. How do you feel with Mason back that Mason and Riley will work this out the rest of the way?
Well, I think it's up to Mason to worry about working it out, not Pat Riley. I do believe that the next time that it happens, he'll be gone for a long period of time, if not for the rest of the year. I mean, no coach of the quality of O'Reilly is going to take total insubordination, never mind all of the other business that was given on the bench in front of a sellout crowd in a big game.
John Starks with a foul, his 4th. Jordan back to the line again. Remember, the Bulls have been in the penalty here going to the line since 5-minute mark of this third quarter. If Jordan hits these free throws, the Bulls will regain the lead. They have trailed by as many as 14 in this game. It's tied. Michael has 45 points.
When you worry about the Knicks, Bob, off of 93. Back then, even up and into 94, their differential was 6-7. Last year it was 7. This year their differential is only 2.5. That tells you that they're not scoring and they're not as ferocious defensively as they used to be.
10 of 11 from the line for Jordan. 46 points for Michael. 4 points away from tying his Madison Square Garden record, an opponent against the Knicks of 50 points. Smith with the fake. Good defense by Chicago. Inside Mason.
Nice.
Ewing. Jump hook over Longley. Good interior pass.
Excellent call, Bob. See, that's another quality that Mason possesses. He's a terrific ball handler for a guy his size.
Jordan. With 46. Rims out of there. Run down by Pete Myers. Corey Blunt. Pete Myers with 15 on the shot clock. Michael's saying, bring it back out. Myers is going to take it in anyway. They probably should have brought it back out.
You know what happened there? Patrick Ewing left Longley, and instead of Longley going to the front of the rim, he stays outside, so Myers had to force the shot.
Yeah, Longley is normally much more effective offensively. Smith missing, Jordan rebounding. Bulls with a chance to take the lead, down 80-79. 30 seconds, a three-pointer. Right up for Michael Jordan. He has 49 points. His next field goal will break the Madison Square Garden record by an opponent, and we're in the third quarter.
He shot that from the Garmin Center. Are you kidding? He was outside the building on that one.
3 of 4 from three-point land for Michael Jordan tonight. Harper, turnaround jumper from 12 is good, and that'll tie it at 82. 9 seconds to go in the third quarter.
Derek Harper has had a very, very solid game.
Jordan misses at the buzzer. It's tied at 82. Ho-ho! Jordan about to break the Madison Square Garden opponent scoring record set by a youngster in 1986 from North Carolina named Michael Jordan. Welcome to Broadway. Michael's here in the house tonight, and Craig Sager's with another great New York star.
Well, Bob, sitting front row for this possible record-breaking performance by Michael Earl, the Pearl Monroe. Next basket, he may set a record, most points against the Knicks here in the Garden.
Well, that's tough. You know, it's a tremendous performance for a guy who hasn't played, even for a guy who's been playing for a while. It's a tremendous performance.
How would you guard him?
Well, first of all, I'd make sure that he didn't get off the bus to get in the building.
All right, thanks a lot, Bob.
Pippen with the steal. Curve in the bucket. That's a two. The Bulls lead it by two. Shortened by quarters. 20 in the first, 15 in the second, 14 in the third.
Yeah, but what this is showing you how one guy cannot do it by himself. What we have seen is Pippen and Armstrong have stepped up their game.
In the third quarter.
That's right. And the quality teams have the three players that must get their points and shoot the high percentage. Those two guys have really come to life.
Luke Longley just picked up his fourth personal foul. Phil Jackson tried to rest Jordan for 3 minutes in the second quarter. An 11-2 Knicks run. Bob Neal, Hubie Brown with you from Madison Square Garden. Michael's return to Broadway. Bulls leading 84-82. We have 11:28 to go in the ball game. Jordan getting a brief respite here. His next field goal will break the record for most points scored by an opponent against the Knicks at Madison Square Garden.
Now in this game, the Knicks are 21 for 30 from the foul line. They have missed 9. They had missed 5 in a row until Patrick just made that last one.
Kerr for 3.
Oh boy.
87-83. You know, Kerr second in the league in three-point shooting behind Detlef Schrempf.
Steve Kerr is shooting 51% in threes.
Greg Anthony in running the show at the point right now to Charles Smith against Kukoc, double team.
Oh, beautiful.
Beautiful pass in to Anthony Mason.
Well, that's the old rule. When your man leaves you, big man, to double team, please go to the front of the rim, and if the guy can pass it all, he'll find you for a layup.
Kukoc gets it inside to Pippen. His fadeaway doesn't go down, and Mason. You see the Bulls' weakness on the offensive boards. They just don't have the Horace Grant rebounders. Kerr popped in the chin by Davis. Seems to be okay. Another good interior pass. Bulls' interior defense not there.
Well, they're double teaming, see? And when you double team, that opens up one of the two big men on the other side of the lane, and they're finding them.
Tied at 87. Charles Smith with the steal.
Give it up. Give it up.
And Kerr brings him down. Now you're right, he should have.
Yeah, now see, if he gave that up, they would have had a layup. Now this should be a definite two-shot hard foul. There's no doubt about this. Now you're going to see, now as they come on the break, keep to the top of your screen. See, if he gave that ball up right there, they never would have gotten that. Now, I'm stunned that this is not a two
right
in the ball.
Not a flagrant two. Charles Smith will get two shots, period. B.J. Armstrong about to get back into the ballgame for the Bulls. Tied at 87, 10:09 remaining. These are potential first-round playoff opponents, Chicago and New York. over the past few years during the Bulls' run at the championships. It's been Knicks, Bulls, and except when Michael was gone, the Bulls have been the thorn in the side of the New York Knicks.
Well, you can see on the bench there, Michael Jordan and Pete Myers were having words, whatever caused that.
I think he was probably talking to him about the time that he wouldn't come out with it. Longley inside, Harden!
Yeah, human call for that. He looked like Big Country Reeves on that. Come on, it's about time.
Bulls by one. Mark Davis, shot clock to 10. Herb Williams.
Nice fake.
Smith for the offensive board and the putback. Knicks up by a point. To follow up on that, when Pete Myers was in, he had the ball inside. Jordan wanted it out high, wouldn't give it to him, and that's why Mike was talking to him on the bench. And Pippen just drains the three. Bulls by two. Hubert Davis. Herb Williams gets along. Longley got a piece of it.
See, he has the talent, Bob, to be the missing link for them. He can shot block, he's a big body. He should be able to score for you down inside, but you must do it every night.
Kerr from Longley, nowhere to go.
Plenty of time, plenty of time.
7 seconds.
Nice,
and the foul.
Beautiful, beautiful. And this is why you love watching Scottie Pippen play. If you notice, he's total motion. He's been going all night long. Now just watch this little hesitation. He looks off the one defender as he extends it, takes it right to the rim.
Pippen, 17 points, 6 rebounds, 7 assists. At personal on Herb Williams. Bulls by 4, 8:36 to go in the game. Jordan on the bench resting with 49 points. B.J. Armstrong commits the foul on the attempted steal. Let's check the team foul situation, because both of them fouling early here, particularly the Bulls. That's their third team foul with 8:27 to go. Knicks have committed only one.
Right now you can see with 8:27 to go, Phil Jackson is trying to buy Michael Jordan some extra time because they have the 4-point lead.
There's the screen and roll. Traveling, Bulls ball up by 4.
Since the first quarter, the Knicks spacing inside has left a lot to be desired. Plus, they're kind of out of sync. They're not getting any type of perimeter game shooting. Give Chicago their due at the defensive end.
Ewing on the bench for New York. Herb Williams playing Longley. 8 to shoot. Armstrong. 4-3! It's a 7-point Bulls lead. Timeout, New York. The Garden crowd is quiet. An 8-0 Chicago run with Michael Jordan resting on the bench. With just under 8 minutes to go in the game, time for the Dutch boy in the paint. Patrick Ewing, who has been resting, is now back on the court.
Well, you can see he's dominating, but then again, the Bulls centers do not get any shot attempts. The second effort points you can see right there. But let's face it, the Knicks had 34 points in the first quarter. They've only scored 56 points in 2.5 quarters.
And Luke Longley got the block on Ewing there right out of the chute. Kukoc over Ewing, hit the side. Longley for the offensive board.
I tell you, the young guy can do it. Unfortunately, he doesn't play like this every night. But he has tools.
Bulls have their biggest lead, 99-90.
Big thing is you've got to go to your bread and butter if everyone else is struggling, and they have to start going through Ewing and get the catches, and Patrick must answer the bell here.
Patrick has 25 in the game. Kukoc inside. Nice defensive job by Charles Smith. Knicks on the run. Jordan moments away from re-entering the game along with Derek Harper. And Kukoc picks up the personal foul, and that's five for Kukoc.
Now that's the Bulls' fourth for the quarter.
Yeah.
So the Knicks will be shooting the penalty on the next foul.
Corey Blunt in along with Michael Jordan. Blunt and Jordan, Longley, Pippen, and B.J. Armstrong on the floor as the Bulls lead by seven. Knicks, however, will be shooting the penalty, and that'll make a significant difference down the stretch. Knicks have committed only one team foul in this quarter. Ewing over Longley and the foul.
Now Longley got a little confidence. He blocked two shots. Patrick didn't give him his best moves. Now the last two times down, Patrick has stepped up his game, and he's given him some moves. Well, you have to respect Longley because of his size at 7'2" and the long reach.
Longley just picked up his fifth foul. Phil Jackson will probably use him in, as Phil says, having three centers gives him 18 fouls at that position.
The Knicks have now missed 12 foul shots.
Yeah, big. 99-94, Bulls, 6.5 to go. Michael gets his own board, knocked out of bounds, and saved by Harper. Nearly knocked out by Charles Smith, who had the block.
Michael is angry with himself because that was his easiest shot of the night.
His next one will break a record of opponents scoring against the Knicks.
There you go. And the foul.
The Knicks come roaring back. It's a one-point game and will be tied if Ewing hits the free throw.
The two shot blocks by Longley have awakened Patrick Ewing. The last three moves, very, very strong. Now Longley fouls out of the game on this move with 5 points and five rebounds. Strong move by Patrick. That's the second time this evening, Bob, that he has spun to the baseline and then rather than throw the fadeaway, stepped under the defender and reached up for that shot.
So he fouls out with 5 points. Ewing, 29 points, 20 in the second half, will Purdue in for Chicago.
The big key, though, is the Knicks' inability to make the foul shots. That's a major issue in this game.
Bulls 99, Knicks 96, can pull to within two if Ewing hits the free throw. But he doesn't. Purdue rebound. 3-point Bulls lead. 6 minutes to go in the game. Jordan back in. 49 points for Michael tonight. Isolate the side. Screen and roll right by. There's another block by Charles Smith.
Well, Charles Smith averages throughout his entire career with the Clippers in here right at two shot blocks a game. So you know, now Michael goes in here, he thinks he has it, but Charles right up on that shot.
Frankly, it looked like it could have been a foul too. Nevertheless, it wasn't called.
Well, you're looking for the record. See,
I'm looking for the record.
Some,
if they'll get the record, I'll quit refereeing. Give him the two. Starts against Jordan to Ewing over Purdue.
Ewing has 31. What a show tonight.
Michael Jordan.
When you finally go to your guy, your bread and butter guy, what happens?
8-0 run by New York, all scored by Ewing. Bulls by one. 10 to shoot for the Bulls. The Garden is alive. Jordan, fade away. Not again. Purdue follows. 101-98 Bulls. 5:11 to go in the game. Ewing has been the man for the Knicks. He has scored their last 8 points. Harper leading in.
Oh, big shot.
Pippen rebound.
Now I know he thought he was going to get fouled.
Right.
Because the next foul. Well, they're already shooting a penalty.
Looking for Jordan. Sounds like the name of a book.
Michael wants to clear out. He wants to take starts.
Blocked that time by Ewing. Corey Blunt back with a putback. The Bulls offensively rebounded.
Yes, because they're catching the shot blocks. They're coming right back to them. You're giving them offensive boards. No, the shot blocks are coming right back to the Bulls.
Jordan driving, being batted away by Ewing and Charles Smith. Back to Ewing. Open man Harper. This is the three. Blunt loses the rebound to Smith. Ewing misses. Pippen for the Bulls. Up five. 4 minutes to go in the game. For Pippen. Good play by Starks moving Purdue out. Intercepted The pass attempt for Ewing. B.J. Armstrong with the ball. Bulls by five. What a wild game. And Phil Jackson sees the five-point lead and wants to settle them down. The Knicks have committed three team fouls. The Bulls already in the penalty with 3:53 remaining. Starks, that's the fourth team foul against the Knicks. And Starks, fifth.
Well, Starks has been taken right out of this game, you know, from a scoring standpoint, when you think about it. Now, Michael Jordan is struggling. He has missed eight of his last nine shots. For the game, he is 18 for 32.
Isolated against Starks, carrying five fouls. Jordan from 16. There's the record! That's the record of the most points scored against the Knicks at Madison Square Garden. Jordan's old record of 50, his new record, 51. Now the record is over, Hubie, I can relax.
Yeah, it takes me out of the record book because I was coaching in that game.
I was going to say, I wonder how the coach felt. Ewing, however, answers over Purdue. What a show we're seeing from Patrick Ewing here in the second half. And number 33 has 33. Bulls by five.
Nice defense by Mason.
Plenty of time, 10 seconds. Offensive foul as Jordan breaks down John Starks.
Yeah, that was a good call. Michael knew it. Starks very active, was trying to front him. Now keep an eye on it right there. You're going to see Michael put him down. Knicks need some smart basketball right here, Bob. They need a score or a couple of foul shots.
Bulls up by five. Ewing has the last 10 New York points. Pippen kicked the ball. That'll reset the shot clock with 2:50 to go in the game. New 24 seconds, and Ewing has the last 10 New York points.
Now, if you notice on that post up by Charles Smith, Scottie Pippen is the designated double teamer from the top of the circle. That means the ball would be rotated out to Anthony Mason.
Charles Smith being played by Corey Blunt.
Oh, good denial by Michael.
Starks had stepped out. Jordan got into the passing lane. 10 to shoot. Starks into Ewing. There's the double team.
Nice.
Man, Mason fouled hard, missed the lay-in, but excellent recognition by Patrick Ewing.
Terrific. Patrick was triple teamed on that. You could hear Mason call for the ball. Patrick, and I'll just watch as Patrick, they're running right at Patrick. He just looks right down inside to Mason. Now the Knicks have really made that a major contributor for them offensively in this game.
Blunt picked up his fourth foul. The coach is going to come back in for the Bulls. New York, 23 of 35. They've missed 12 free throws tonight.
Now that's big in a game like this. When a game is close like this, naturally the free throws, big issue.
Anthony Mason steps to the line. He's only a 62% shooter at the line, but he hits both of them there. Bulls by 3 points. Jordan with 51, Ewing with 33.
High screen and roll.
Jordan with 53. My, oh my.
It was like Starks wasn't even there, okay? Because when he elevated, he just left him in the dark. Nice move by Starks.
Yeah, good pick by Patrick Ewing.
Phil Jackson on that side over there wants an offensive foul. Now you can see that as Starks goes into the pack, he is totally out of control because as he goes up in the air, he turns his back. Now Phil Jackson, depending upon the angle that you had on this, you want the offensive foul.
Kukoc has fouled out of the game. 3 points, 9 rebounds for Tony Kukoc tonight. He has contributed on the boards, but seems somewhat lost in this triangle offense since Michael is
now keep an eye. See, Starks surprises him. Now here comes Kukoc. Now just watch that. The offensive foul.
Under the hoop.
Yeah, well no, hold on.
Was it
under the hoop? You think
was
so?
Was under the hoop?
All right, let's look to see if he's under the hoop. Tony Kukoc said, hey, over in Europe where I was player of the year 3 years in a row, that's a foul. That's an offensive foul.
That's the only possibility. Otherwise, I couldn't agree more.
As a matter of fact, whatever you say, I'm going to finally agree with you.
Let's keep an eye on it now. Let's see if Kukoc is out of the lane.
Close.
You're right. It's close. But I agree also. I wouldn't get it. If that was playoff time, he should be shooting the tip.
And he is at 107-103 Bulls. Thank you, Yubi.
High school and college, definite offensive foul, no doubt about it. NBA, we have different rules for different players.
And they are different players. It is a three-point Bulls lead, 2 minutes to go in the game, playoff intensity, all the stars are out. Broadway in the springtime in New York, Jordan with 53 points. Loose ball foul is going to be on New York. Oakley leveled Purdue.
Yeah, well, that's because he moves him out on that rebound. Bennett Salvador was right there on that call. I just hope that we have a good shot. And we're going to show it to you, kid. It's going to be right to the right of your screen. As this shot goes up, watch what happens here now. Now, what they're saying is that Oakley moved him out with his forearm.
Oakley's fourth foul, team's fourth. On the next one, the Bulls will be shooting. Knicks already at the line. Looking for Jordan, the lob inside. Ewing there to help Purdue. Hard to the rack, blocked by Patrick Ewing. What a play! Harper!
Well, now you have to go into Patrick, see what happens. Go right back at him.
Now fronted by Purdue.
Sure, he's got to make it happen.
Ewing outraged, as are the fans here in Madison Square Garden.
Everyone wants the continuation. Now keep an eye on Patrick rotating. There's your block. At the other end of the floor, see the whistle blew right there, and that definitely was a continuation. That was a continuation. They don't get the call.
Patrick showing that disappearing is the wiser move at this point in the game, instead of getting in the face of the official and coming back for his free throw. Doesn't get it. Pippen, by the way, now carrying four fouls for the Bulls.
That's the 13th miss for the Knicks.
From the line. 107-104 Bulls, 128 to go in the game. Patrick Ewing has been alive here in the second half.
Oh, yeah.
Got one of two. Michael Jordan with 53 points in this game. Ewing with 34. Starks with five fouls. Jordan's fadeaway blocked by Ewing. Starks, good pass.
Look out, dunk it.
Yes.
And brought up to their feet. It's tied at 107. Right now, Michael is forcing the action right now. The last three times down the floor. When they have played their best in this half, they just all played within the offense.
He forced it again. Goes to Pippen.
Oh,
hard angle bank shot by Scottie Pippen. Or was that Sam Jones?
Had a bad name out of the past because he was the best. Sam Jones out of North Carolina Central College and one of the great all-time Celtics. Now keep an eye on Patrick. Patrick gets that shot. That's his fourth block of the game, third this quarter. When they kick it out, look at Jordan running Starks down. He knows he better send it home strong. Now, how about the angle on this bank? Oh, my.
He had to hit it at the edge of the backboard. There's the reset. Bulls 3-1, timeouts. Knicks 2-1.
Plenty of timeouts.
Under a minute. Bulls by two. Pressure defense. 10 to shoot.
Patrick wants the ball. He has 35 points. Oh, he gets bailed out on that.
The call, and once again, we talked about it earlier, Yubi. If it's Cartwright, maybe or maybe not a foul, but Purdue and Longley and Winnington don't get the respect from the officials that way, and they get the fouls. Longley's already fouled
up. Well, it's a major issue. There's no doubt about that. Now, right now, Ewing has 34 points, 25 in the second half. He has 7 rebounds and 4 block shots. Now, he is now, for himself, on the foul line tonight, 15 for 22.
Timeout, Chicago. Jimmy, you said it during the commercial timeout. What a great game. Bulls by one, 39 seconds left. Spike Lee, so many celebrities here tonight, and they are glad they didn't sell their tickets.
Absolutely. Now, this was an excellent timeout by the Bulls. They're icing Ewing. He's 15 for 22 on the line. He has missed seven. Timeouts, Chicago has 2 and a 20. New York, 2 and a 20. Both teams are shooting the penalty. So we have plenty of timeouts. Now watch the people getting into the lane as he pauses and he gets up to his shot. There it is.
It's tied at 109. Jordan working on Starks. Got him in the air. Michael Jordan has 55. He had to work for them.
He did. Starks played him as well as you could, using his forearm to neutralize Michael as he was trying to make the penetration.
And carrying five fouls.
Oh, yeah. First to the left and then to the right. But then again, that's why he's the greatest. Because all he did was extend. Now, just keep an eye on it. He extends. Now, how about this? Outstanding presence of hit fake and then regrouping to get the good shot. Now, just watch how he regroups. Now, here comes the fake. Gets Starks up. And then, there it is.
55 points for Michael Jordan tonight. If you dialed in late, sorry you missed something. He had 20 in the first quarter, and you could tell that it was going to be one of those nights for Michael Jordan. He loves to play at Boston Garden. He loves to play at Madison Square Garden. Michael loves to play at the Forum in L.A. Put him on stage, and you're going to get these kind of performances. His all-time career high, 69 points. But he broke the Knicks record. If you see David Stern, who, you think David's happy that Michael came back?
Oh, I would think so. America's happy. Yeah, okay. Now, right now, Chicago has two timeouts. New York only has one timeout in a 20. With 25.8 seconds on the clock, New York usually will involve Starks and Ewing on the left side of the floor. They will normally get the ball in bounds, work misdirection, and come back. Now, Ewing should be involved because he is the guy who has carried him throughout this entire second half.
There's the game reset. Bulls with two timeouts, two fulls and 120. Knicks have only one full left, and that's significant.
Yes. Now, at the other end, Chicago has got to say, if Patrick catches the ball, we must double team and force the other people to beat us right now. Because Patrick is in a groove. Double hard, force the rotation, and let's see what happens with these other people.
25.8 to go in the game.
Now, they could move it to half court. They're not. They're taking it here and coming up in normal play. That way, it saves them from possibly getting denied on the inbounds pass. There's a pick and roll.
Starks against Perdue. Phil Jackson exploded. And that will be six on Perdue. Both Longley and Perdue have fouled out of this ball game.
Now that time, they ran a pick and roll, and Starks just decided to take it. From this angle, from that shot right there, that is an offensive foul. You can see Perdue is there, and Starks had nothing, jumped right in his chest, but it doesn't matter, he gets the call.
He's out winning today. Starks 12 points. He is 3 of 4 from the free throw line tonight. Bulls up by 2 with 14.6 to go in the game, and Kukoc, Longley, and Perdue have all fouled out of this game for Chicago.
Well, you have to make the foul shot. Starks is a 72% shooter.
Within one.
Now we told you, Chicago, two timeouts and a 20. You do not necessarily have to call a timeout. As a matter of fact, you catch people sleeping if you take it out of the net, if he makes it, and you flow right down the floor.
14.6 seconds remaining. Starks rattles it in. It's tied at 111. Timeout, Chicago.
Now, Chicago decides. At that time, they're calling the timeout. It'll be interesting to see. Will they take it at half court or on the baseline?
Saturday night against Atlanta, the Bulls were down by one. They went to Michael Jordan with 5.9 left. Could we see deja vu? This is Saturday against Atlanta over Steve Smith. Bulls win.
Well, they took it down at the end, but that's where he rebounded the ball and took it up the floor. The big key right now is, if you're the Knicks, do you allow him to hold the ball, milk the clock without double-teaming him, and then for them to get the last shot and a potential offensive rebound? Now, you see they're taking it at the full length of the floor. This allows the people to move, run time off the clock, and it also opens up the floor so you're not trying to get the ball in a half-court area.
Steve Kerr in for Chicago, and Bonner has just replaced Hubert Davis. Pippen will inbound. Mason, Bonner, and Starks are defending.
They have Armstrong and Kerr in there as their spot-up people, because they're saying, are you going to double-team Jordan? If they do, if you double-team, they're going to spot up.
Michael finds the open man. Weddington with a jam. 3.1 remaining. Timeout, New York.
That was outstanding. Who has been double-teaming him in the lane?
Patrick Ewing.
And that was by design. He took it right down the middle of the floor. The Knicks stayed with Armstrong and Kerr in the corners. And then what did they do? They sent Ewing out, his man, right to the front of the rim. Now just watch this. Here comes Ewing. Great pass, because there's Weddington going to the front of the rim.
Jordan, 2 assists in the fourth quarter.
Now give you another angle. Beautiful pass. Smart basketball. When your big man leads you to double team, go to the front of the rim. This is the best angle so you can see it. Beautiful. Now the Knicks, plenty of time. 3.1 seconds, okay? 3.1, we know that you can catch the ball and get off at least 2 dribbles here. The big thing, though, is you must get the ball inbound. That's the key thing for the Knicks. You've got to get a good pass. Now remember, when you have Pippen and Jordan on the floor, you have 2 of the best in the history of this league at playing the passing lanes, forcing turnovers. Now, you know it's got to be something quick. Is it an inbound pass inside to Patrick Ewing, or is it to a Starks off the dribble? Pat Riley, through his 4 years, has always used Ewing and Starks in some manner.
3.1 seconds remaining. New York now all out of timeouts. The Bulls have 1 remaining. It's a 2-point game with 3.1 seconds to go. You see what the Knicks have decided to do. They have moved the ball to half court. Weddington will try to defend Patrick Ewing. Longley and Perdue have fouled out along with Kukoc.
All right, now there's your delay in game by Pippen stepping out.
To take a look at what they were going to run.
Now you can see right now there's going to be a down screen in the lane here for John Starks. He's going to right here. Here's Starks.
He falls down, loses the ball over the
backcourt. Backcourt violation.
Tenths of a second left. That delay of game was brilliantly executed.
Well, yeah, everyone in this league does the delay of game.
It was a great time.
But you can see as he comes up in here, Michael had him on the hips. I do not think that caused him to slip. All you have to do is throw the ball in here and one of your guys just get a piece of it and the game's over. Right there, a great win for the Chicago Bulls.
Michael Jordan, 55 points. In this ball game, the Bulls beat the Knicks 113-111. Let's go to Craig Sager. Craig.
Well, if you're going to make a comeback, you better come back as good or better than you have before. You surprised people all over the world. How do you feel personally about your performance tonight?
Starting to come back to me a little bit. I felt very good tonight. I shot the ball very, very well. I felt myself in great rhythm tonight. And, yeah, I guess the big point of the game was the fourth quarter. You know, when I was sitting, you know, the other guys came in, gave me a chance to rest, and, you know, it was a great effort by everybody, really.
How have you been able to maintain your focus throughout this, particularly today in New York with everything that's happening here? How'd you do it today?
Well, you know, I go through my normal routine. You know, once I'm on the basketball court, the rest of the stuff doesn't make a difference to me, you know, because I'm in my dreamland. You know, this is what I enjoy doing. I love playing the game of basketball. And once I'm out here, no one can really do anything but let me play the game of basketball. But everything pertaining to this, I mean, you know, it's a lot of hoopla going on right about now, but I've been through it. I feel sad for my teammates because some of those guys have never been through what we have to go through sometimes, getting in the hotel, getting out of the hotel. But me, I'm pretty much used to it, and, you know, I'm at ease when I'm out here on the basketball court.
You've renewed a rivalry, but how do you feel now about the team compared to 2 weeks ago when you first started thinking about coming back?
I still think we need to work on our defense. I think everyone's putting a lot of emphasis on rebounding, but, you know, we gave up a lot of easy baskets defensively. And, you know, even though I scored a lot of points, if we played solid defense, you know, it shouldn't be this close.
55 points, but nice assist at the end.
Hey, don't count on me shoot it every time. I can pass.
Okay, back to you, Bob.
Thank you, Craig. Michael Jordan set up the game-winning basket on that pass to Bill Winnington with 3.8 seconds left. Jordan, with his 55 points, 21 of 37, made three of his last four after missing 8 of 9 in a slump there in the fourth quarter, is, shocking, I know, our Budweiser player of the game. And as you see, it's his 34th career 50-plus point game for Michael. He also broke his own Madison Square Garden record for most points ever scored by an opponent against the New York Knicks.